averaging a few gigabytes per file, Diffusion models can quickly take up a lot of space on your hard drive. In this video, I'm going to share with you some tips on how to manage models more effectively. First, let's talk about native solutions. Many of the popular repos already have built-in logic to help access models outside of the application. I recommend this approach for most people watching as it's super easy to configure and manage. For example, if you're using Comfy UI, the extra models path.yaml.example file, which is located in the root directory, is made available to access assets outside of Comfy UI. Here you can either reference your existing automatic 1111 installation directory if you already have assets there, or any other directory on your machine. To configure this file, just remove the word example from the file name, then paste in the location of the automatic 1111 web UI or your custom asset folder. Once set, you can restart Comfy UI and it will automatically detect and load models from that specified directory, so now you don't have to keep track of the files in two places. Now, if you're testing out the newly released web UI Forge, the developers there created a special command line argument that allows you to reference the installation location of Automatic 1111, and it will effectively pull in all the relevant assets from Automatic 1111 web UI so you don't have to download or copy over anything. Lastly, for both Forge and Automatic 1111 web UI users, the command line arguments such as checkpoint directory, VAE directory, lower directory, and many others can be used to reference directories outside of their respective applications. A link to the official docs of all the command line arguments are located in the description. To use command line arguments within either of these applications, just open up the web UI user file and set them there. And then you'll just want to make sure that you restart the application for the changes to take effect. Aside from the developer-supported options, symbolic links are another way to manage all sorts of Diffusion-related assets. Symbolic links are simply just shortcuts or aliases that point to the actual file or folder location on your operating system, kind of like a shortcut icon that you might have in your desktop or in the dock. Making symbolic links is really easy. For Mac and Linux users, you just want to go ahead and open up Terminal Window and then put in the following command, ln-s, and then define the source and the target. So for example, the source is where the models are stored, while the target is where the shortcut will be located. This creates a symbolic link between Automatic 1111 models directory and the models folder, allowing Automatic 1111 to access and use these models just as if they were stored within its own directory. Now, if you're on a Windows machine, you can create symbolic links using the mklink command, which the structure will look like this. This is a little different than the Mac and Linux command, but the concept is still relatively the same. So for example, if I wanted to bring in a model from my models directory to the Stable Diffusion web UI directory, I would go ahead and put in the following command. Now, on the other hand, if I wanted to bring in the entire directory, you gotta make sure that you pass in this slash D flag just after mklink, so it will go ahead and reference the directory. Lastly, I just want to touch on hard drive considerations. If you have a traditional disk drive that you use for general file storage, such as family photos, game assets, and so on, it's best to avoid putting Diffusion models on there because they will have a slower read and write speed when compared to, say, a solid state drive. And what this means is that whenever you go to load the model, say within Automatic 1111 or Comfy UI, it will take significantly longer. So if possible, keep all your models onto the solid state drive that you use regularly. And you can, of course, offload those older models that you might not use as frequently to the external disk. So there you have it, a few different ways to manage and share your Diffusion models across many different applications. I hope that this video is helpful, and if it has, please consider subscribing and liking the video. Thanks for much watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.